Okay, so yesterday I came across this tweet, which I thought was interesting, around the idea that LLMs are really going to be a threat to white-collar professionals when they can generate slick PowerPoints better than humans. And while I found this sort of semi-amusing, I also thought it's kind of true, right? That a lot of people, their jobs seem to just be making PowerPoints and perhaps doing email on top of that. So what I thought I would do is try out just to see, okay, with what's the current state of building a PowerPoint deck with an LLM? Now, I've deliberately not gone for doing an agent kind of framework. So maybe in the future, I will do this sort of video again with agent frameworks and look at how well that could be improved upon. But what I do is I just take the sort of top LLMs that we've got out there, and I've chosen three of these. So I've chosen ChatGPT Plus, which is GPT-4. I've chosen Claude 3 Opus, and I'm going to use the Google Gemini 1.5 Pro model in here to try these out. So where possible, I'm going to use the same prompts for each of these models, and I'm going to try and see if I can to try and use the same prompts all the way through. All right, so we're kicking off with ChatGPT Plus or GPT-4, and I've basically just asked it a very sort of generic, simple question. What is the best way to make a PowerPoint slide deck programmatically? And you can see that what it's coming back with is it's suggesting a number of different packages or frameworks that you could do this. I'm not sure about Markdown or LaTeX there, but okay, we've got some things going on in the ideas in here. If we give the same thing to Claude, and you'll notice I'm trying to use, like I said, I'm trying to use the exact same prompt each time. When I give the same thing to Claude, it's also giving me a list of different kinds of frameworks. But one of the things that's nice about it is that it's actually giving me some sort of code examples of how I can sort of see this as I go through here. Okay, and then finally, when I give it to Gemini 1.5 Pro, you can see that we're getting back a similar kind of things, talking about different frameworks and stuff, although some of the frameworks are different in here. And it's almost like they're all sort of trying to clarify something, like what language are you using, that kind of thing. All right, so I'm going to follow up with the same prompt for all of them to clarify this. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to ask it to make a set of slides about the five good emperors of Rome. So if you come and look at just doing a Google search, Google generative AI search here for the five good emperors of Rome, it clearly knows what emperors they are. And it's giving me, this is the generated stuff with an LLM before it actually then goes on to give me search results and stuff like that. So we know that an LLM should know what these five emperors are, etc. So I've clarified that ahead of time. What I've also done is I've gotten a couple of books about these and converted them into text files so that we can actually try uploading the books and getting the LLM to use this as a resource, maybe for a second round going through, etc. Okay, so here's the next prompt that I'm going to go with. So I'm going to basically clarify that I'm using Python. Okay, let's say I'm using Python. Give me a code example that will generate 10 slides about the five good Roman emperors with two slides for each of them. I want it to be creative and very stylish, as if it was designed by an advertising agency who creates ads for Paul Smith. For the info on the slides, have the emperor's top five achievements. For the content, let me just put a comment there. For the content, approach it as if you are a top four consulting company making a pitch. Actually, we'll just say making a pitch deck. All right, so we kick this off in here. What I'm really curious to see is like, where do they strongly go for the same kind of thing? And where do they strongly differ in their outputs? So I've got GPT-4 going there. Let me just kick Claude off. So I'm really curious to see sort of where are they similar, where are they different, not just in the actual sort of specific content, but in the way that they respond to this. It's interesting that this one got the subtitle, a pitch by top four consulting. So maybe I should have used the actual consulting names there. Let's give this one to Gemini and kick that one off. And while that one's running, let's come back and see what GPT-4 has done. Okay, we can see here that they've all settled on this particular package, which I haven't used before. So eventually I'll try and build these and see what these actually look like. Add emperor slide. So it's got a function there. Okay, it does look like it's got the five emperors correct here. All right, we've got Nerva, Trajan, Hadrian, Antoninus Pius, and Marcus Aurelius. Okay, so it's putting those together. I don't really see anything about styling in there. So this code provides basic structure to truly capture the Paul Smith style. You should enhance this with this. Okay, so we'll see if the other ones do the same kind of thing. Okay, so it's basically kicked off. It's got Paul Smith colors. Okay, so it's very interesting. Just Googling quickly what the Paul Smith colors are, you can get a sense of this kind of stripy color there. So it's definitely defined some interesting colors. I wonder how it's actually going to use them in here. And we can see that it's also defined nicely the top achievements of each of these, which is, I think I said the top five achievements from memory. Yep, I said the top five achievements. So this seems to have paid attention to that and responded quite nicely in there. And it's basically telling us that it's going to make this out. So this is almost like that it's saying that this is already done and ready to go. I think this one we will sort of try building it. Gemini has been going. So Gemini, we've got an interesting thing here where it's done it for two of the emperors, but then it's just sort of said, oh, I'll add details for the others in here. And then it hasn't really got anything about the Paul Smith colors or anything. Although it's got a font name, Paul Smith handwriting. Again, kind of interesting because that there is like some kind of font like that. My guess is that it's probably not easy to get that font. Okay, I'm not seeing a direct link to that font when I actually come and look that up. What else do they have got in here? It's got for this. Okay, the first key thing I think is I need to tell it that you need to give me the details for all five emperors. Okay, so I'm going to give this same prompt to the other ones, although I think the Claude one may have already done that, but let's just pass that in for each of these. This one actually looks like this one did do something along the lines of what we actually wanted in here. And this time we've certainly got some nicer formatting coming out of it for that one. For Claude, okay, certainly here is the complete code with the details for each emperor and the content for each slide. Okay, so it seems I messed up copying it across where for some of them I had a slide for each of them. For the ChatGPT one, I had two slides for each of them, although it doesn't seem like it's made the extra slides there. It seems to be sticking to one slide for each of them. Continue generating. All right, so I think now what I'll do is I'll copy the code over, install the packages, and we'll start to see actually how well do these actually work. So I've managed to get the code into VS Code for each of these. You can see I've basically got one for the ChatGPT slides, one for the Claude slides, and one for the Gemini slides. I will say that the Gemini one did have errors in it, and it required me going back to it multiple times, asking it to fix its own errors, because I deliberately didn't want to fix any of them myself. It was just basically forgetting to import different things in here. And it was only when I basically said to it, come on, like you need to get your act together kind of thing, that it was like, I sincerely apologize for repeated errors. You're absolutely right. These mistakes aren't acceptable. And then it actually did fix all of the code in there. So I've gone through and basically just run each of these and given them, just changed the name at the front to be, you know, so that we know where they came from for going up here. And what I'm going to do next is basically upload them. I don't have PowerPoint on this machine. So upload them into Google Slides and we can basically have a look at what we get up there, knowing that's probably not the perfect way to evaluate these, but at least we can sort of see and get a sense of what they were doing, what they were thinking in here. Okay, I guess another way I can basically check them is just to sort of use the preview tool in the Mac to go through them. So this is the ChatGPT ones. They come out pretty much normal sort of boring slides. The content, I haven't gone through the content thoroughly, but it seems reasonably sort of right. Yeah, focuses on Marcus Aurelius meditations. It's got some different sort of things in there. If we have a look at the Claude one has the colors, or certainly is getting at some of the color ideas from the Paul Smith thing in there. Very sort of boring layout of the slides, right? It hasn't really sort of nicely proportioned them in any way. But we do have like when they actually ruled, you know, the ruling dates for each of these. Although we've got things overlapping each other, which is also not ideal. And then we can see with the Gemini one, we've basically got some sort of repetitions of things. And I'm guessing we're missing something. This could be because we're looking at something that's black on black. Okay, so if we bring these over and bring them in, we can actually see what they will look like in Google Slides. So we can see that the ChatGPT one has gotten stuff, although it looks like it's bleeding across the edge on Google Slides, although that is probably a Google Slides issue rather than a PowerPoint issue in here. Again, we've got, I guess looking at these, we've got the content in these, but we haven't, you know, exactly got nice layout in here. Okay, when we look at the Gemini one, and it's interesting that the errors that the Gemini one was getting was it was trying to put in images and it just was getting errors because those images didn't exist. So you could imagine if we had prompted it that, okay, here are the five images we've got, use those in here or something like that, we could have gotten some better results. This is not good though, where it's basically giving us Trajan's accomplishments and one of the five accomplishments is he was considered one of the five good emperors. That's not really holding the context of what it is that we're sort of going for in here. Again, with Marcus Aurelius, the idea of that one of his achievements was the thing that we're actually making the deck about really perhaps signifies to me it didn't really understand what I was going for in here. It does seem though that the main issue is the issue around design. What I want to do is go and have a look at a product which I actually use quite a bit, which is all about getting LLMs to create nice designs by using certain components. And while it's not actually doing sort of PowerPoint slides, it's doing websites. So let's jump in and have a look at that. Okay, so another service that is not exactly PowerPoint, but it is kind of, I think, in the same realm, is that of websites, right? And this is a service called v0.dev, created by Vercel. You can see I basically put in a prompt in there, and the prompt was create a website about the five good emperors, have sections with pictures and profiles for each emperor showing their name. Now, I didn't tell it anything about the five emperors. It's basically using the large language model that's running this. I'm guessing it's OpenAI for this, but it's either got a lot of good things in context in here, or it's got a fine-tuned model. So what basically v0.dev is creates websites and you can come through and look at them. So we can see here that this one, we've got five good emperors, Trajan, Hadrian, Antoninus. Okay, so it's got one of them wrong. So it's missed out Nerva, the first one, and it's added Marcus Aurelius's son, who was probably not considered one of the good emperors. He was a bit of a crazy guy. If we look at some of the other ones, though, here we can see, again, it's getting some of the content wrong, but definitely stylistically, it's much more kind of interesting here. Now, I haven't put in the stuff around the advertising agency and stuff like that. We can certainly come through and try that out. And we can see this one hasn't done a very good job at all on that one. But the whole idea with V0 is that once you've got something, you can then reprompt it. So now I can basically ask it, use the colors of a Paul Smith design. Let's see what it will basically do is take what we had there and then sort of remake it. So obviously we looked before at the Paul Smith colors are very flamboyant, very colorful, and it's kind of gotten the colorful thing. I'm only seeing two colors in here though, so that's not exactly ideal. But one of the things that, you know, I'm kind of thinking is that you could imagine a service or an agent that allows you then to look at the slide output and then sort of reprompt it and basically improve on it and say, okay, I like how you did this slide, but change this other slide. I need more information about this. I need more information about that in there. And I think that is probably not that far away. My guess is that there are probably startups out there already working on this if there aren't already products that exist really for doing this. It's kind of an interesting problem to do in that I think it's definitely a tractable problem that you could do with LLMs. The issue becomes how do you deal with design features and putting in colors, etc. So I'm just taking the colors from the Claude one and I'm just going to say remake it with these colors. So you can see that even as it's remaking it here, it wants to stick to a limited number of colors on the page. Now that could be something in its prompt about telling it not to be sort of just too many colors or something, that stick to sort of two or three colors and hone in on those, which it seems to have done with both the yellow version and this other version as well. Anyway, I thought this would be a fun little exercise just to get a sense of how different or how similar the ChatGPT models, the Claude models, the Google models are when we actually start putting these together. As you can see from the slides that we got out, still got a while to go before we could just do this with the off-the-shelf LLM. We're probably going to need an agent. We're probably going to need some kind of functional prompting and some system that understands about design a bit more and understands about how to take it. So I think it's interesting that the LLMs have been able to get the facts that we were sort of after. And you could imagine if you preloaded them with context for your company, for your project, that kind of thing, it will be able to get that. And especially if you imagine it that in that context, you've got things like a recording of a meeting that you had about the project, a set of sort of agreements, notes that you came about for that project, that kind of thing. It should be able to do those sorts of things. I think the challenge is going to be making it the design look really slick and also getting the style in a way that people are going to be happy with it. So I think there are some slide creation tools out there that once you've got your facts in there, you can sort of just click the button and keep changing styles until you get something that you like. And you could imagine that would work really nicely here. Anyway, this is just a fun little playful thing that I wanted to try out on the weekend. Let me know what you think. Let me know your ideas on how to make this better. If people are really interested, maybe I look at sort of writing an agent to do this or writing some kind of thing to do this and have a go at making it better as we go through. Anyway, as always, if you found the video interesting, please click like and subscribe, and I will talk to you in the next video. Bye for now.